The question that I hear over and over again, be it from your investors or be it from the millions of Snapdragon users and fans around the world, is how is this fundamentally going to change the operation and functioning of a personal computer?
Oh, yes. That's the reason we're very excited about what we're doing. And I think the endorsement we get from Microsoft, I think the presence of Microsoft in our event as well. We have been working to build the next generation computing device for the Windows ecosystem. And it comes with where we see the convergence between the mobile and the PC. It comes at a time that users want more mobility and more performance, and the whole experience becomes an AI experience. And I think that's what we did with the Snapdragon X Elite announcement. First of all, we're incredibly proud, and especially as we've been talking, that Qualcomm is changing from a communications company to a connected processor company. We just unveiled the fastest CPU of any mobile computing device, of any laptop in the world, fastest CPU in terms of performance. We have the device here, people could test it. That's gonna allow for you to have a lot more performance for your day applications, but also to have a lot of AI on the device.
Cristiano, we were submitted dozens of questions from our audience, including Snapdragon insiders on Discord, for example. And actually, a reoccurring question was how the latest generation CPU can handle specific AI functions like Microsoft Copilot, for example, on device. Can you give us any insight there?
Absolutely. So what is interesting about what we've done with this processor, not only has the fastest CPU for your everyday tasks and gaming and all of those things, but it has a separate engine, and that is a unique differentiation from Qualcomm. It's called the NPU, and it's about allowing your AI to run pervasively and always running on the device. So the Copilot will be always running on the device to assist you with every task. And the NPU is the biggest that you can in performance you can find on the device. Just an example, we can run large models of 13 billion parameters natively on the device. And we show that we have been partnered with all the major ecosystem investing on AI, from Microsoft to Meta to Google and many other companies, in having all of those models running natively on the device.
It's a fascinating moment in terms of competition, Cristiano, as well. It was but a couple of days ago, reports that NVIDIA is going to be challenging the space as well with its own ARM-based processors for PCs. You've got Apple, of course, showing its prowess in the area. How do you set yourself apart from what is going to be a real rush to the PC area?
I actually think the announcements that happened, especially the NVIDIA announcement, is one of the best things that could have happened for our efforts in the PC. We have been talking for a while, since we embarked on this journey with Microsoft, that the PC market is moving to an ARM compatible, away from the x86 into an ARM compatible instruction set. The NVIDIA announcement is the validation that that is the new market and that is the new TAM for Qualcomm. It comes at a perfect time that we have been diversifying the company and looking for new opportunities and end markets for our technology. And we had started on this journey for at least the past 3 to 4 years. I think 24 with the new Windows AI, that comes to fruition. It starts to be at the end of the 2024 material for Qualcomm. So we're really excited about that. And we look at all those announcements and endorsement that this whole PC ecosystem is moving to. And we just developed the fastest ARM CPU in the world.
We've got, announcement potentially as soon as next week with Apple M3. When you've got a competitive but a validated space, as you seem to be articulating, what volumes do you anticipate in one, for example?
Well, we're not making projections. I think we have been very careful, especially because this is a new market for us. Think of us as a new entrant. And if you look at the size of this market, I think even if we get a smaller share, it's a significant growth opportunity for Qualcomm. And we're excited about what we have developed. The part is competitive. And one thing we haven't mentioned about it, besides the performance, the power, which is our DNA of making very power efficient devices for battery life, is incredible. We exceeded the performance of the fastest CPU you can get from Intel for gaming, but we do it at 70% less power, as an example.
For our Bloomberg television and radio audiences worldwide, we're joined by Qualcomm CEO Cristiano Amon from the Snapdragon conference in Maui. You just mentioned power. The claim is that it's about 68% less power than the comparable Intel processor. A really fair question is the price premium, though, that your latest chip has. A lot of questions from global end market users was like, well, how much am I going to have to pay over the nose to have access to a consumer electronics device that carries Snapdragon X relative to mid and lower tier smartphone or PC?
I'm going to answer that question two ways. The first one is, we're going to enable with this product for you to have a thin and light laptop that you can have the performance that you would find otherwise on a high-end gaming device. So I think, if anything, we're going to be democratizing technology and make that and AI running on device available to more people. And that's easy to understand given our mobile heritage. The other part of that is, actually, we look at the Snapdragon Elite X actually as a premium Snapdragon solution, which improves dramatically our mix, and it has great financial contribution as we look at the margin of those products. So I think it's a win-win for both sides.
One thing that you guys do really well is look at Snapdragon and this kind of fan base you have. You know, everyone has raved about the H100 GPU from NVIDIA all year, but I've noticed this kind of deep Reddit forum discussion, Discord channels dedicated to Snapdragon. How much do you take into account the feedback from those community in your development of the product and what it can actually do?
A lot. I think one of the things we do well is we have been nurturing this community. By the way, both of you should be in Snapdragon Insiders. You may be missing out. And we've been nurturing this community. It's growing very fast. It's over 14 million. And those are tech enthusiasts. And they really love the technology. They're advanced users. And they give us a lot of insights. And we really like that relationship.
Ultimately, I mean, I remember when we were first coming and sitting down with you a couple of years ago, it was all about supply chain issues when it came to chips and how you navigated that. Is there any sort of concern when you're thinking about unleashing these new, more powerful PC processors?
No, the supply chain, I think, crisis we had in the semiconductor industry is behind us. And we actually look at into the future as the most exciting thing now is how AI is developing on device outside the data center. And it's going to touch phones, it's going to touch PCs, it's going to touch cars. And we're looking, maybe we have an opportunity to create a whole new cycle in the phone business and generate growth in the phone business as well with AI.
Cristiano, I want to be sort of reflective for a minute. You and many of your peers have tried to bring ARM-based CPUs to PCs for a decade. And fundamentally, the personal computer has not changed for a decade. The ecosystem around x786, for example, massive. It's been tried, tested. Why now? Why is this going to be any different from what you've tried in the last 10 years?
Okay, let me bring you a different perspective, because there's a number of different vectors that are changing the PC. And by the way, I think we need to say Apple did a very good job when they developed the M series and creating a PC that based on a mobile SoC architecture. And that's one of the things that we have been working to do the same and create the best possible performance next generation PC for the Windows ecosystem. But the reason this is different, first of all, I'm talking to you right now via my PC. And PC became a communication device. We took working with mobility to the next level. And then the biggest piece is the fact that AI is changing the user experience. If you think about Microsoft's doing a Copilot, even what Microsoft said about the price of the Copilot, which I actually think is inexpensive if you think about the productivity increases they can do for many enterprises, that is changing. It's going to be a different type of device, and that's what we're working on, and that's going to be a bright new feature. We're going to bring a lot of excitement and hopefully a new upgrade cycle for PCs.